day by day,
week by week, month by month, year by year, decade by fucking decade, I shall do and continue to have done and shall continue to do my twice daily meditation practice. The never-ending disjointed river of the stupidest, pissy-ass thoughts crash upon the metamorphic rock of the field of infinite silence lying at the root of all sentient consciousness. I wield my mantra like a machete, relentlessly hacking through the dense thicket of neuroses, anxieties, and self-loathing, ever searching for the holy grail of pure silence that is the ocean out of which we emerge. Like little metal ducks constantly coming into view at one of those shooting galleries, I am the wannabe marksman shooting the thoughts down one at a time. Does the deliciousness of a woman's pussy correlate with hair color? If so, where do redheads fit in? Boom! Silence. Will civilization collapse completely, or will it be more like a stair-stepped punctuated equilibrium sort of thing? Boom! Silence. That time that Annie Sprinkle wrapped her epic breasts around my face, boom, silence. How am I gonna hang that rim joist when I'm too unambitious of a carpenter to have a helper? Boom, silence. What is the optimal size for a woman's breasts? Boom, silence. How will sweet, gentle hippies be able to fight off criminal gangs of mutant zombie tweakers? Boom, silence. As much as I may love big cassava melon breasts, you gotta feel for the poor women who have to lug those things around all the time. Boom! Silence! A science fiction film where some annoying guy is boning some woman but doesn't realize that she's actually extraterrestrial. Then at the height of passion, his whole body starts getting sucked into her pussy like a rabbit getting swallowed by a boa constrictor. Boom! Silence! Never underestimate the potential found in neuroplasticity. The idea that our consciousness can be shaped or molded over time. It's the morning of the first day of your new daily meditation practice. You meditate for 20 minutes, you instill a degree of silence and peace, and then you go about your day and the silence fades. In the evening, you sit down for your second meditation, but what you don't realize is that there's still 0.00000001% of the silence and peace remaining from that morning's meditation. You then finish off your evening, and in the morning you sit down for your third meditation. But what you don't realize is that there's still 0.00000002% of the silence and peace remaining from the previous two meditations, and so on. This is how you can systematically groom and condition your consciousness over a period of time. Although most of us have little direct experience of it, it is part and parcel of sentient consciousness that we all have a vast ocean of silence, clarity, and peace lying deep inside of us. It is the space between the thoughts, or the field lying beneath the thoughts. It is eternal. It was here before we were born. It'll be here after we're gone. It is what we all share in common. It is where we are all one. And we can be doing much stupider things than getting to have an intimate familiarity with that deafening roar of silence. Thank you.